Hello. I had a really rough day today. After the fight that I had with my husband last night and a little bit of arguing that we did this morning, as you could see, I was in tears last night. I mean, this morning. As you can see this morning from my video post this morning, my video journaling this morning, I was really upset. And I went to work and I had a rough day, but I got through the day and now I'm on my way home. So I want to talk to you real quick. So something that helped me get through my day was a lot of self-talk. I was able to vent out some feelings to a coworker friend, and I listened to some self-help codependency therapy. Lisa Romano, I think that's her name. On YouTube, you should check her out. I was extremely trying to soak in everything that I could to help myself feel better. And I kept toying back and forth with this notion that I've got to choose. I've got to choose between living in a miserable marriage where I'm controlled and, or having this double life with him, right? Or leave him. And in many ways, I still see those two as my only options. But I'm striving for a third option. I'm really pushing for the middle ground on this, the gray. If it's not black and it's not white, I really want what's in the middle. I really, really, really want it. And what I really, really want is to be myself, be my happy, awesome self while I'm in this marriage. And if he doesn't like it, he can pack a bag. He can kick me out. He can do whatever he needs to do. And I think what is really tricky about being codependent and still staying married is obviously you love him, right? Obviously you want the best for the marriage. Obviously you don't want to hurt him. And everybody else that's struggling with codependency that I've ever talked to, which is just a few people on a Facebook group page, so I don't really know them, but they talk about no contact. You can't do no contact when you are married. Now, you can do it to a degree. Like, I used to message my husband a lot while I was at work. I used to call him almost every day on my way home from work. I used to call him randomly at work and just vent about whatever, money or kids, school or whatever. I used to really be attached to him, like super glued to him. And I have completely cut off those unhealthy attachments to him. And so I don't call him. I don't talk to him. Now, there's some text messaging that we still might do, especially during this fight. We've messaged a lot back and forth and while we're at work. And even those, I haven't really read what he's written me. I see a big long thing and it's just justifying his feelings, and it doesn't matter what he said. I don't want his words to affect me the way they can sometimes. So why do I have to read them? I'm not doing very good as a wife if I can't address what he's referring to in his message. But I need to protect myself first and foremost. So that's the one end of the spectrum. The other end of the spectrum is I really want to stay married and figure this out and get past it and be triumphant. And it would be awesome if I don't have to leave him to do that, and I don't have to stay miserable to do that. So hold on one second. Okay, my mom called, and I know you guys don't want to watch my sob story and everything, but I'm just I'm just venting to myself. I'm trying to give myself therapy. I'm trying to give myself help. I'm trying to rise above everything. And I didn't want to leave today's video on a sad, sorry note. I wanted to feel like I'm empowered again. So that's why I had to close today's videos with a little bit more, a little bit more surety. What do you call it? A little bit more oomph. Like, I'm really happy that I am finding this strength in myself again. And I think what helped me the most out of everything, what helped me the most was writing down some words to remember on some index cards before I left work. It was almost like giving myself a quick pep talk. So I'm going to read these words right now on camera, and then I'm going to read the words this weekend if I should be faced with any more self-doubt or codependency things where I feel like I've got to save him or fix him or help him or apologize for his emotions. All right. One of the first things Lisa Romano said, which I thought was very helpful, was, I accept your reality of who you think I am. By accepting his reality of who he thinks I am, I'm letting go of the control on trying to get him to like me, trying to get him to give me approval or acceptance. If he thinks I'm terrible, I accept the reality of who he thinks I am. Another one, I am not his perspective. So just because I accept it doesn't mean I need to believe it. I am not his perspective. So if he thinks of me as a whore for watching a TV-14 show, I am not his perspective. I'm not a whore. Something else I wrote down is, I'm sorry if my actions hurt you. That doesn't mean I'm sorry for doing my actions. That doesn't mean I'm never going to do those actions again. It just means I'm sorry if my actions hurt you. That's giving sympathy, that's giving compassion, that's giving understanding, that an acknowledgement and validation that you're hurt. He's hurt. I'm sorry if my actions hurt you. But I made no promise of not doing it again or fixing it for you. Another thing Lisa Romano said is to excavate when you're challenged with something. Find out the when, the what, the why, the how of your emotion. So like if you're angry, when did you become angry? What were you angry about? Why were you angry? How long were you angry? Or how did you become angry? Like all those things. And same with sad and fear. Just ask yourself questions and become very interested in discovering those emotions and developing them so that you can process through them and get to the next part, which is self-love. I am a good person and I make good choices. Again, just something I need to remind myself. And then I will not let anyone or anything control my actions. And then another one is, I am the master of my emotions. I choose love. I love myself. I love my husband, but I don't have to choose to be controlled. I am the master of my emotions. I don't have to choose to feel like a victim. Today, I begin a new life. I am evolved from my former self. So any past mistakes I made or any choices I did that he didn't approve of before, he can't hold me to those things that he's angry about from the past. I am evolved. I am different than what I was. I will greet this day with love in my heart. I will persist until I succeed. I am nature's greatest miracle. I will live this day as if it is my last. I will laugh at the world. I choose to be happy. I will multiply my value 100-fold. Anyway, I'm not really sure how this day is going to unfold for the evening, but I am proud for how I was able to overcome my own struggles with this stuff so that I could rise above the waters, climb back up on the ledge, stay away from the ledge as much as possible, and go and face my fears. I am stronger than I used to be. I have different modes of thinking now. I have different tools in my tool shed. Better tools in my tool shed. I can totally handle anything he brings to me. Anything. I can get through it. And I'm doing it without meds too. That much I am very proud of. Imagine how much better I'd be if I did have meds. I'd be so much better at this, but I don't like the side effects that the meds brought me, so that's why I had to stop them. Alright, I am on my way inside the house. Talk to y'all later. Better video next time, hopefully.